So let us take few more questions in our C programming and problem solving. So now this is B equal to A plus 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 A. What will be the output? Now you have to really do it on your paper and then tell me what will be the answer. Did you get the answer? The answer is E. Now how this has become E, let me tell you. A is 10 here, so plus plus A will make 10 as 11. Since this is post increment operator, so it will not be incremented here in this expression, it will remain 11. So 11 plus 11 is B, that is B is 22, so B will be printed as 22. So we'll take this one. Now here it was 11. While A++ was going on, it was 11 only. But after this line, it will increment because this is post increment. So it will become 12. Now 12 will come here. But this is plus plus A. So what will be printed? 13. This is A, so that will be 13. Again, this is post increment operator. So after this line, it will be incremented. So it will remain as 13. So the answer is 22, 13, 13, 13. Next is my salary was increased by 15%. Select the statement which exactly reproduces the line of text above. The answer here is, can you guess the answer? These are options for you. The answer is D. First of all, this double quotes needs to be printed with a backslash. Then only this double quote will be printed. Then we have percent here. How we are going to print percent? We have to use 2%. 2%. And then we have exclamation. And then what about this double quotes? Again, we have to use the escape sequence, that is backslash. And everything remains same. So D is the answer. Next is, this is a character pointer, star ptr. Can my string is equal to abcdefg, let it be double quotes also. Ptr is my string, so my string is assigned to ptr, and ptr plus is equal to 5, that is 5. So at first go, it will be incremented by 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so fg needs to be printed A. But the answer is exactly this only, so there is no catch. We have a pointer, character pointer, we have again this character my string, so this is also a character pointer, so these both are same, you can assign them. Now if you increment this or you increment this by 5, this is ptr plus is equal to 5, this is ptr is equal to ptr plus 5, that will be incremented 1 2 3 4 5, and fg, because the pointer will point to fg when it is printed, only fg will be printed. Next is, which one of the following will declare a pointer to an integer at address 0x200? Which of the following will declare a pointer to an integer at address 0x200 in memory? Now this is a very good question. You have to answer this. The answer exactly is what you have been thinking. This answer is A. We have int star x, that is a pointer x, then star x is equal to 0x200. All will be fine. Okay. Next is x equal to 3, counter equal to 0. While x minus 1, so in bracket inside a bracket, while x minus 1. Plus plus counter will be incremented, and x will be decremented. So x is 3, so first x minus 1, that is 3 minus 1, that is 2, it will become 2, and now x minus minus, that is what is x now? 3. 3 minus 1, that is 2, so 2 2. Again it will go back, and this is 2 minus 1, that is 1. X minus minus is what? X is our value which this x is taking, that will be 1 minus 1 1. So again, when it comes to 1 minus 1, it is 0, it will not come. So what referring to the sample above, what value will the variable counter have when it is completing counter? So it will run for 2 times. So intuitively, it is giving the answer as 2. Okay, the code is 2. So answer exactly what we have thought. It will run 2 times, so answer will be 2. The counter will have 2 value. Next is, what is the result of the following code? We have x equal to 0. It will go to 0, and k0 is cout 0, and then it should be printing 0. But the catch here is that it will be printing 0 hello world. Why? The answer of 144 is nothing but A, this one. Why? Because case, it is actually switch case and break scenario. You don't have any break. So when it comes, definitely it is going to skip case 1 because 0 is coming. So it will go to this case, but when it reaches this case 0, 0 will be printed. After that, what happens? There is no break. So see, case 2 will also be executed. So hello world. So 0 hello world will be printed. Next is, you have a test array. It's a test array 4, 3. So 4 rows, 3 columns. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we have to print the size of test array. What will be the size? Assuming a short, this is a short, so short is 2 byte long. Let us consider it to be 2 byte long. What will be printed by the above code? Give me the answer. Tell me the size of test array is what? See, 4 into 3, we are only worried about the test array. Test array is what? Test array is 4 by 3. So 4 by 3, this value will be assigned. 4 into 3 is what? 12. And space is taking 2 bytes. So multiplied by 2, 24. So when we print the size of test array, it will be 24. Next, which one of the following will read a character from the keyboard and will store it in the variable C? Variable C. So these are the options for you. Which one of the following will read a character from the keyboard? It is accepting from the keyboard. So we have to see that it should be coming from the C keyboard. The answer is, can you guys guess the answer? The answer is E. C is equal to getChar C. So getChar is the function to read a character from the keyboard. Okay. Now next is, what does the auto specify do? Auto. Auto is a storage class. So it will automatically do something. We don't write auto int x equal to 0. We just write int x equal to 0. So what does this auto specify do? The answer here is B. It indicates that the variable's memory will be automatically preserved. So the B is the answer. Next is 148. How is variable accessed from another file? How is variable accessed from another file? These are options for you. How is variable accessed from another file? The answer here is A. The global variable is referenced via the extern specifier you are going to use. Now, these are underscore, just consider to be double quotes, right? Okay, which one of the following is valid for opening a read-only ASCII file? Read-only ASCII file. So these are few options for you. Now you have to tell me what is the correct answer. You have to give a valid instruction for opening a read-only ASCII file. The answer here is E, fopen file name read. E is the correct answer. Next is, what is the meaning of self-referential structure? Self-referential structure. The answer here is, these are the options for you. You have to tell me the correct answer. The answer is C. Structure calling its parent structure is self-referential structure. The answer is C. Next is, read the following statement and choose the most appropriate one. Now, I want you to read all this. I'll give you some time. Please read them very carefully and just try to answer. So, read the following statement and choose the most appropriate one. The answer is C. Second and fourth. That means an algorithm is a set of rules for carrying the calculation either by hand or a machine. These are set of rules. Okay, it can be formal, it can be informal. You can write it in a pseudocode or you can just write a flowchart. So this is an algorithm. It's a set of rules for carrying calculations either by hand or by machine. Then the fourth one, which I am indicating as the correct answer, is an algorithm is an abstraction of a program to be executed on a machine. Next. Is the answer in the previous one. Let A be the integer variables and PQ are the integer pointers. A be integer variables, PQ integer pointers. Which of the following are valid in the C program? So, 152. What is correct? The answer is E. P is equal to P plus A. Why? Why? Because according to the integer arithmetic rules for pointers, all the operation P is equal to P into A. P is equal to A by P, P is equal to P by Q, and P is equal to P into Q. They are invalid. These are invalid. Okay. So this is the only valid expression. Read the following statements carefully and pick the correct answer. Now you have to read this. I'll give you time. Read them very carefully and try to answer. Which is true, which is false. Let me give you the answer. The answer is, can you guess the answer? The answer is A. 1 and 2 are true. That is, an external variable declaration must begin with storage class specifier external variable. While the scope of the automatic variable can be smaller than the entire function. Yes. Second, the third is false. That is, an automatic variable keeps its final value even after the function is terminated. No. Only till this value. This functions only. That is why it is automatic variable. 154. Pick the equivalent control structure for the following repetitive control structure. Even semicolon E3, semicolon E2 statement. For statement. So pick the equivalent control structure. for the following repetitive control structure? The answer is, now can you get the answer, which is the correct one? The answer is D, E1, while E3 statements E2. Okay, this is the correct option. For the initial values A3, B40, C13, D10, what is the final value? D, and this is a cap C, and D, ampersand A. So what is the correct answer? Okay, let me give you the hint. The answer is, say, 39. Will it help you in answering this, or it is going to be 39? So I will leave you, this as an exercise for you. The answer is 39. But let me tell you how you're going to do it. First, you have to find out the representation of these values. And then I'll just tell you that this is an XOR operator, XOR. Okay. And this is an AND operator. This is an OR operator. The first, you have to compute the XOR one, then the AND, then the OR. This is the precedence. So you have to find the representation of these values, find the OR of B and C, then the D and A AND, and the final OR of these two. You'll get 39, of course. Next is, find the output of the following statement. The initial value of X is 20. X is 20, so what will be the answer? Can you answer? The answer is C. This is the answer. Why? First, it comes to 20, we'll go from right to left. X minus minus. What is X minus minus? 20. 20, because this is post decrement, it will remain as 20. Then we come here. Okay. Now, again, with this 20, has to be incremented. Okay. So what will be the incremented value? Because after this, x minus minus, x minus minus means 20 has become 19, then 19 plus plus is 20. Okay, 19 plus plus has become 20, and then this has become 20, so minus minus x will be 19, and then x minus minus, this will be happening after printing the value, so again it will be 19. And now, because it has already decremented, because it will decrement after this, x minus minus is what? That is, again, we'll get the similar scenario here. So x plus plus will be, again, 18 will be printed. So minus 1 will be 18, and 18 will be printed here. Okay. So this is the answer. What is the correct output of the following program? String H. This is, say, IFI University. We have reverse. So string length, j equal to 0. This is reversing the string. Now you're placing REVJ equal to slash 0. So the first value in REVJ will be slash 0. Put S will be, you know, REV. So this should be the reversal of this string. So reversal of string, but the answer would be, you know, we have already done this type of question, so answer will be our D, nothing. Why? Because slash 0 will be placed after this Y T, and likewise till this one CI. So this is okay. REV reverse has the reverse value, the reverse string of this string, but the first value slash 0, once this put S encounter slash 0, it will print nothing. It will just stop. Choose the correct output of the following program. We have A equal to 10, B equal to 11, C equal to 13, D, then what will be the answer? What happens here, D will always be assigned the value at the rightmost, right? So C is equal to what? A plus B plus C. A plus B plus C, that is 13 plus 11 plus 10. It will be 34. So our answer would be what? Why it is A? Because we have to compute this also. And in this question, the initial values of variable is A, B, C, 10, 11, 13. So then first A equal to C, this will be done. Then this, then this. So it will be, let us see, A equal to C. Let us do it here, A equal to C. First this will be done, A equal to C. So A will have value as 10. C will have value as, C was having value 13. So A will become 13 because of this. So A is 13, C is 13. Now B is equal to B plus A. What was B? B was 11. What A has become 13. So what it will be? It will be 24. Now finally you have A plus B plus C. So what is now A? A is 13, B is 24, and C is what? That is 13. So what it will be? 6015. So answer will be A. This is the answer. And this will be assigned to D. Next is, consider the following code. You have an array 68390 equal to 0. If you have a break, then print, then else print. So what will be the answer? I just want answer from you. What is the output of the program? Please read it very carefully, because we have already covered this type of questions earlier. The answer is syntax error. Why? Because you have break inside if will not allow, if you cannot place a break inside your if, this is not possible. So the syntax error is because break can't be used with selection control structure, but can be used with repetitive, like while, for, or select control structure. This is wrong. Okay. The next question is, while declaring an array in C as data type, array name, size, the size can be, what size can be? The answer is any variable. Is it any variable? Or say b, an integer constant? We'll go with the integer constant, because the size at declaration can't be any constant. What if it is say 32.12, float constant? It can't be any variable. So what if it is some variable when variable is a float variable? So any initialized integer variable is also not allowed. So we go with any integer constant. Next is, in C, which of the following can be used to create the constants for float values? In C, which of the following can be used to create the constants for float values? Enumeration, const, and hash define. The answer is very obvious. The answer is C, second, third, constant, and define. Enumeration is not for this. So 161, the answer is C. Next is, choose the correct output of the following program. We have a main which is calling function 10 and function 3123. This function has variable parameters. So first it will give 10, what it will give 3123, and we'll see what happens. First you read it and try to solve it, and then I'll tell you the answer. The answer is it this 1234? And if it is this, then why? You have to give me the correct output, because it is same as the variable length argument list. You know, you are printing what? You are taking I equal to 0, star p equal to %b, that is the pointer of %b. Now you are printing the space, that is you can see the space, and then I is less than a, you are printing i++. So once this printing of +++ star p++ will go on, this p, which actually it is pointing to the b value, so it will start with your 1, okay, and then this one, second value, and we are incrementing it, so it will be 2, 3, and 4. So it just incremented from 1, that is this value 1, 2, 3, and again since it is incrementing, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Next is, which for the following input function scanf, %d, %*d, %d, %x, and %y, the value insert enters are 900, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6. What will be the values integer variable x and y? What will be the values of integer variable x and y? Can you tell me the answer? Is it 976? And if it is there, then the reason. Because we have a format like this. %*d. This is okay. %d will print what? 976. But what this will do? This form %* format specifier suppresses the input and do not store it in any variable. Hence 4, 5, 6 will be skipped. It will be skipped. So it will give only the first and second last value, that is 976. Now this is the question for you. What is the output? You have a equal to 5. Then you are giving the reference to PA. PA will now be pointing to A. Now you have B equal to 0. Now you are providing your PB will be pointing to B. Now you have address of PA. This is address of PA will be given to star of star PA. So this is address of PA. That is the pointer which is pointing to A will now have the address stored at PPA. So PPA will be pointing to PA now. And now what you have done, PA is given to PB. You have PA is assigned to PB. So now they have PA and PB will be pointing to the same value. Okay. And this is A plus is equal to star PB plus is equal to star star PA. So what will be these values? It's quite complicated, but you can do it. I know that you are going to do it. The answer is this one, A, 20, 0. Why? Because of the pointer, first of all, this and this one. And pointer to a pointer, this one. And the short form, plus is equal to. Because A plus is equal to star PB is equal to star p ppa will give answer as 20 0 20. And why it is so? Because the star ppa, this one, so here will be 5, and this is 5 plus 5, that is 10, and then again 5 plus 5 plus 5, that is 15, and then again a is added to it, 5, that is 20. So now you know that these and these two are pointing to the same value, so that will be 20 here, and b will retain its value because b is only 0. Okay, b is, we are directly printing, so the answer will be a. That is, what is the output of the following program? You have a structure which is a having value ji. We have a function. In this, we are passing this structure temp with pointer to a structure. Then we are printing the star p and p plus plus we are doing, and printf. In this main, we have a structure temp. We are already assigned the address of a to this z, and z I equal to 1, so this has value as 1. Z j is 10, so 1 and 10 value I and j has, and then the function z is called. So we are passing the value. Now we are trying to print the value, p plus plus, what will be the value. So the answer here is, it will be 10 and 0. And this is very obvious because the set of statement structures, this I and 10 has been given the value. So pointer is pointing to the first field, and hence in response, the printf, this one. So it is printed, it will be printed, or it will be printing the value of j, and see the order int ji. This is not ij, this is ji. Okay, the order. So in structure definition temp. So once the pointer is incremented, it crosses the current structure variable and pointing to some other location. So in response to this printf, this one, this line, the output was 0. Okay, this, that is why the answer would be like 10, 0. So in this, we'll go with 10, 0. So these are a few more questions on C and problem solving. We'll be taking more of it. Till then, thank you so much. Take care.